Hello, it's Keith here, and this is lesson 15 of the 6502 assembly programming tutorials. This week we're going to be looking at joysticks again. We're going to be looking at the NES and the Famicom, which are of course the same system. The Famicom was just the Japanese name for the Nintendo Entertainment System. We're also going to be looking at the Super Nintendo, and the reason for this is that the code is basically identical. Now, I think this comes back to the original heritage of the Super Nintendo. It was originally intended to be backwards compatible with the Nintendo NES. That's why it uses the 65816 processor, which is actually slower than the 68000, but it does have 6502 backwards compatibility. And I think the reason the joysticks are backwards compatible is for that reason, that they were hoping to use it. Anyway, we're going to be using the same code to read in from our joysticks today on the NES and the Super Nintendo. So we're going to look at them today together, because they say they work basically the same. So how does the Famicom work? Well, we have two ports that we read from and one port that we write to. Now, when we read from the joysticks, we read in one bit at a time. Each bit is, of course, a button on the joystick, up, down, left, right, fire one, fire two, select start. Now, when we read these in, first what we do is we send a strobe bit to 4016. This is a reset. And then we read in a bit one at a time from 4016 and 4017. Now, bit 0 of 4016 is joypad 1, and we will get all 8 buttons consecutively from that port. The same with 4017 for joystick 2. Now, joystick 3 actually uses bit 1 of 4016, and joystick 4 uses bit 1 of 4017. Now, of course, by default, there are only two joystick ports on the NES, but you could get an extension device that would split that out. So that's how that works. Now, when we read in this order, the bits are going to be in slightly the wrong order, but we're going to swap them around. When it comes to the Super Nintendo, believe it or not, we use the exact same ports. As I say, very convenient, far too coincidental. It was obviously intentional. Now, we still get two fire buttons, select, start, up, down, left, and right. However, rather than just doing 8 reads, we can actually do a full 16 reads. We're not going to in this case. We're using a common format in our tutorials. Up, down, left, right in the first 4 bits, fire 1, fire 2 in the next 2 bits, and then a select and a start or a fire 3, depending on the system. So we're only going to read in 8 of the buttons on the Super Nintendo, but there are another 8 we can read in, and all we would need to do is just continue reading in those single bits from that port, which we'll see in a moment. Now, I assume, I've not tested it, but I assume that if we wanted to read in joypads 3 and 4, we would use bit 1 again. That bit 1 is certainly connected to the joypad hardware. I've looked in the documentation, but I've not tried it because it's really outside of what I'm planning to do in these tutorials. But that's just a fact there. One other thing I should say, I guess, is on the Famicom, there was a microphone port. It doesn't exist on the Nintendo NES, so don't try and use it on the NES and think anything's going to come from that. Now, that's how we read directly from the hardware. There is an alternative way on the Super Nintendo. There are some variables that are set by the firmware automatically during interrupts. So we've got these addresses here, and these will read in the joystick buttons automatically for us. It's a bit more convenient. I guess we don't have to do this bit reading code that we're going to look at today. But to be honest, for me, I don't like using the firmware, because now we're reliant on the interrupts working correctly. And maybe we don't want those interrupts to be running. Maybe we need that memory for other things. So as I say, in these tutorials, wherever I have the possibility, I don't use the firmware. So we're not going to look at that. We're going to go direct to the hardware. And as I say, it's the exact same code we're looking at today as the NES. So very convenient there. Not even taking any more time to go direct to the hardware, because we've done the work for the NES already. So let's check it out. So here's my NES emulator here. I've got my two joypads. So if I press up on joystick one here, down, left, right, fire one, fire two, and we've got select and start here, up, down, left, right, fire one, fire two, select start on joypad two there. So you can see we're reading in two joypads just fine there on the NES. Now let's have a look at the Super Nintendo version. So there we go, we're running again, and let's see what we've got. Up, down, left, right, fire, where are they? Fire one, fire two, select, start, and all the same on the second joypad. Now, two of the buttons and the left and right aren't working on the Super Nintendo because we're not reading in those extra 8 bits to get those extra joypad buttons. But we've got enough joypad buttons for our test code today, and this was what was used for Grime 6502. If you wanted to do something a bit more advanced, of course, you could read in those extra ones. But as I say, it's not really within the scope of what we're doing today. That would be maybe something for the 65816 tutorials I'm planning next year, when we start to look at the NES as a 16-bit system, because at the moment we're just treating it as an 8-bit system. Okay, so what about the code? Well, the first thing to notice is that the SNES code and the NES code we're using today is literally identical. Look, there's no difference there at all. The only actual difference is I've changed the comment at the bottom, which shows all of the options you can read in. So we're looking at one piece of code that works on both systems. Very surprising for an 8 and 16-bit system, but that's the case today. So what do we actually do? Well, first of all, we need to do the strobe of the port. Now, what this is a reset. First, we write a 1 to port 4016. Then we write a 0 to 4016. And we're using the X register here to do that. So we load in 1, write it, dex it, and then write it again. So we've written a 1 and a 0 to 4016. This has now set up the joysticks ready to be read in again. What we're going to do next is we're going to shift in the bits from those ports. 4016 is Joypad 1 and also Joypad 3 if we were going to read that in. 4017 is Joypad 2 and Joypad 4 if we were going to read that in. Now, we want bit 0. And every time we read in from these, we're going to get a different Joypad button. So first, we're going to get the fire buttons. Then we're going to get select start and up, down, left and right. So we're going to just shift one bit to the right, and then we're going to rotate that into ZH for player 1 and ZL for player 2. Now, if we wanted to use joysticks 3 and 4, we would need to shift in another bit into another register here, but we're not going to do that today. It's more than we really plan to do. So we do this 8 times, getting a button each time. So once we've got to this point, we've now read in 8 buttons for each joystick, and we've got ZH for player 1 and ZL for player 2. We've now got this function just to convert things around, and all we need to do is we need to set the bits to 1 when they're not pressed and 0 when they are pressed, because that's the standard of these tutorials. And then we need to swap the top and lower nibbles so that the up, down, left and right here are now in the lower nibble, and the fire buttons and start are now in the higher nibble because they were in the wrong order before. And that's really all it takes to get the joystick buttons into the format that we need for these tutorials. Now, as I say, it's pretty straightforward, really. It's a bit odd, this thing of reading in a single bit at a time. I have seen it before. There's a few systems that do this kind of thing, but it's not too bad. And as I say, I think it's preferable to learn how to use the hardware rather than rely on that firmware to do things for us in its interrupt handler. So anyway, that's all there is to it. I hope you found this interesting. Well, of course, we're going to be looking at the NES and the Super Nintendo in other ways in future lessons. So if you want to see more, please follow on to my channel. Anyway, thanks for watching today, and goodbye.